Fulton Bank of Lancaster County has unveiled plans for a major expansion with a $20 million price tag. News 8's Meredith Jorgensen is live at the bank's Penn Square offices with more on that. Meredith?
Hi, Susan. Fulton Bank has existed here at the square since 1882, and its move to expand shows that this financial institution isn't going anywhere. In addition to this prime location, it is now adding two properties just up the street. Now, the bank just bought 22 East Grand Street and 23 East King Street. Now, there were three main reasons for the expansion. The first, space is at a premium in the current building on Penn Square. Number two, the two properties were up for sale. And number three, Fulton says it has a commitment to the downtown. Now, one spot, the parking lot behind Subway, could add as many as 50 parking spaces. Plus, the old bank building will be knocked down and it will be replaced with a new six-story building. That structure will be able to hold 225 new employees. Now, the bank isn't sure yet exactly how many jobs this project will add, but it does say this opportunity comes at a good time.
I think it's important to remember that this economy will not last forever, and it is important to look ahead to the future. We're trying to do that very responsibly. We want to, you know, certainly take our shareholders into consideration and what's best for them, take our customers into consideration.
Fulton Bank says its customers at more than 100 branches should not notice any difference during this transition. But, Susan, people driving along East King Street will probably notice a little bit of a difference. That's because the new building construction will commence in a year or so. There will also be a skywalk, Susan, from this building here on Penn Street over to the building just down the street. That whole construction project should be finished in 2013. The price tag for those two buildings alone, those two spots, $1.2 million. Susan, that's the latest here. Back to you.
All right. A lot going on. Thanks, Meredith.